हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टाइप्स ऑफ कंपास। नाउ वी ऑलरेडी नो दैट वी हैव जनरली टू टाइप्स ऑफ कंपास, दैट इज प्रिज्मेटिक कंपास एंड सर्वेयर्स कंपास। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट विद आवर फर्स्ट कंपास, दैट इज प्रिज्मेटिक कंपास। इट इज द टाइप ऑफ कंपास विच गिव्स द मैग्नेटिक बेयरिंग ऑफ लाइन इन होल सर्कल बेयरिंग सिस्टम। Generally, whole circle bearing system varies from 0 degree to 360 degree and is measured from magnetic north in clockwise direction like this. That is magnetic north. Now, the least count of prismatic compass is 15 minutes and the graduations are marked as inverted in clockwise direction having 0 degree at south. This is very important. That 0 degree at south. Now generally we have the coordinate system like this. At the top there is north, bottom south, here east and here west. Now at north we have generally 0 degree, at east we have 90 degree, at south we have 180 degree and at west we have 270 degree. But in prismatic compass we will do a minor changes. We will write 0 degree at south and moving on clockwise direction, we will write 90 degree at west, 180 degree at north and 270 degree at east. Now we have done a minor changes in our prismatic compass so that we will get the reading directly. Okay. Now in this diagram, magnetic needle is shown here which is attached to the graduated ring which is shown like this. Okay. Now when magnetic needle moves, the graduated ring also moves, and when magnetic needle remains stable, then the graduated ring also remains stable. Now here is the eyepiece and here is object vane or objective. Now one note is there that in prismatic compass the circular ring on which graduations are marked remains attached with the magnetic needle and also rotates with it. We had already seen it that graduated ring is attached with the magnetic needle. When magnetic needle rotates, then graduated ring also rotates. Readings are noted which is shown just below the eyepiece. Here reading is just shown below the eyepiece which is here. Now in this compass, sighting and reading of bearing can be done simultaneously. In this compass, we can sight the object as well as we can read the bearing simultaneously. So, if we will read the bearing and sight the bearing simultaneously, then tripod may or may not be provided with prismatic compass since it can be used by holding on hand also. It means that we can take the reading of any line by holding the prismatic compass in our hand also. Now here is a prismatic compass which is shown in this diagram. Now the prismatic compass is having 0 degree at south which is shown here, 90 degree at west, 180 degree at north and 270 degree at east. Now at this point an eyepiece is shown which is written here, and at the opposite end of eyepiece, here is one objective. Now, needle and graduated ring is already attached. So, if magnetic needle is aligned along the north and south direction, so graduated ring is also remains stable throughout the measurement. Now, suppose that we have to measure the angle of this object which is shown here. Okay. Now we have to rotate the eyepiece slowly and slowly, but as the magnetic needle is attached with the graduated ring, reading remains as it is like this. Only eyepiece and objective will rotate, and we will stop the rotation of the eyepiece and objective till we get a clear line of sight to that object like this. Okay. Now when we had sighted the object, we will directly read the bearing of that object which is shown just below the eyepiece, that is here. And it is in between 0 to 90 degrees, so its angle is 45 degree. Now we will check the bearing of that line with our basic coordinate system that is shown here like this. That is north, east, south, west having 0 degree at north, 90 at east, 180 at south and 270 at west. Now we have the object here. So if we want to measure the whole circle bearing of that object, then it will be measured from the north in the clockwise direction and its bearing is 45 degree. So from prismatic compass we will get the same reading, that is 45 degree. That's why we had changed the position of 0 degree from north to south so that we can get the reading of the object directly. That is all about the prismatic compass. Now we will move to the surveyor's compass. Now surveyor compass gives the magnetic bearing of line in quadrantal bearing system. It means that the magnetic bearing of any particular line by surveyor compass comes in QB system and it will vary from 0 to 90 degree and it can be measured either from north or from south. Okay students, now here is the surveyor compass shown in this figure. Now in this diagram it is clearly seen that the magnetic needle is here, okay, and the graduated ring is attached with the box, not with the magnetic needle. So if the magnetic needle rotates, then the graduated ring will not rotate. It will rotate with the movement of the box because it is attached with the box. And here is eyepiece and objective which is shown here. Now in graduated circular ring is not attached with magnetic needle and remains stable along the line of sight. It means that in surveyor compass graduated ring is not attached with the magnetic needle, we had already seen it, and remains stable along the line of sight. It means that it will not rotate with the rotation of the magnetic needle, it will only rotate with the rotation of the box of the surveyor compass. Now in this method, sighting of compass and reading of bearing cannot be done simultaneously. Now in surveyor compass we cannot sight the object as well as reading of bearing cannot be done simultaneously, because in this compass we have to sight the object first and then we have to log the reading. After that we will read the bearing of that object. Okay, so it cannot be done simultaneously in surveyor's compass. Now the graduations are marked in quadrantal bearing system having 0 degree at north and south and 90 degree at east and west. It is same as that of the our basic coordinate system which is shown here, that is north, east, south and west having 0 degree at north and 90 degree at west and east. Now the most important point in the surveyor compass from the gate point of view as well as from other competitive exam point of view, that the position of east and west are interchanged in the surveyor compass. Now in basic coordinate system east is shown here and west is shown here, but in surveyor's compass we had changed the position of east and west, which is shown here, that is east and that is west. Now why we had change the position of east and west? To get the readings accurately as well as easily. Okay, now we will see how we will get the readings or bearing of any particular line easily. Now in this surveyor compass we cannot take the sighting as well as reading simultaneously, so the instrument cannot be used without a tripod. It means that in surveyor compass the use of tripod is must. Okay students, now here is a surveyor compass shown in this figure having 0 degree at south, 0 degree at north, 90 degree at west and 90 degree at east. Now in this surveyor compass the magnetic needle is not attached with the graduated ring, so if magnetic needle rotates, then graduated ring will not rotate. It will only rotate when the eyepiece and objective which is attached to the box, when it rotates, then the graduated ring is also rotates. So we can say that at eyepiece there will be always 0 degree south, and at objective there will be always 0 degree north. Now suppose that we want to measure the bearing of this object which is shown here. So we will slowly move the eyepiece from this point to this point, so that eyepiece will shift to this point and the objective will shift to this point. Now graduated ring is attached to the box, so at eyepiece always 0 degree south is shown, and at objective always 0 degree north is shown, which is shown here. Now east and west is shown here, which is mutually perpendicular to the northeast coordinate. Okay, now we had sighted the object, now we have to lock the instrument and slowly read the bearing of that object. Now how we will measure the reading? Suppose that at the eyepiece there will be 0 degree south. Now when we move towards the tail of the needle, we will get 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree, 45 degree. It means that it is south 45 degree west. Okay. Now this is the bearing which we had obtained from the surveyor compass. Now we have to check it with our basic coordinate system, which is shown like this. Okay. That is north, south, east and west. Now at north and south there will be always 0 degree, and at east there will be always 90 degree, and at west there will be always 90 degree. Now our object is here, which is shown like this. Now its reduced bearing or quadrantal bearing can be measured either from north or from south, whichever is nearer. Okay, so from south, if we will measure this angle, then it will be south 45 degree west, which is same as that of which we had obtained from the surveyor's compass. That's why we had changed the position of east and west, so that we can get the reading directly with the surveyor's compass. That is all about the surveyor's compass. Now we will move to the errors in compass surveying. Now generally there will be three types of error, that is instrumental error, which is due to the faulty instrument. Next one is manual or personal error, which is generally done by the human beings. And the last one is natural error due to the variation in the temperature of the nature or of the earth. Now we will start with the first one, that is instrumental error. Now this type of error arises due to faulty adjustment of instrument because of the following reason. The first one is needle is not perfectly straight. It means that needle will be like this, and if needle will be like this, then we cannot get the exact bearing of any particular line or any particular object. Now the next one is sluggish needle. It means that needle will not remain stable, it will move like this always. Okay, so if it will not be stable, then we cannot determine the exact bearing of any particular object. Now plane of sight is not perfectly horizontal. It means that the sight will be slightly inclined, and if sight will be slightly inclined, then we cannot get the exact bearing of that object. Now the next one is improper balance of weight of needle. Now if the weight of the needle is improper, then what will happen? Due to the improper weight, needle will be deflected like this, and it will not give correct bearing of that line. Now the next one is readings are marking in faulty way. It means that suppose that here 0 degree is marked, here 10 degree is marked, here 20 degree is marked, here 30 degree is marked. So if readings are marked in faulty ways, then we cannot get the exact bearing of that line. That is all about the instrumental error. Now we will move to the manual or personal error. Now, this type of error arises due to mistakes of the human, that is lack of concentration during compass surveying or lack of knowledge or improper attention. That all comes under manual or personal error. Now, the next one is natural error. It will be due to local attraction, due to local attraction forces like magnetic poles, bridges, steel structures, etc. Next one is rapid variation in declination. It means that the change in position of the magnetic meridian with respect to the true meridian. Now we will see what is magnetic meridian and what is true meridian. And the last one is due to magnetic change in atmosphere because of clouds and storms, natural error will take place. Now, our next topic is the angle measurement technique, which is the most important topic as per the GATE exam. Now, in this technique, we have generally three types of system, that is sexagesimal system, R system and centesimal system. Now, we all know that one circumference will be equals to 360 degree. So, we had written one circumference is equals to 360 degree. Now, in 1 degree, there will be 60 minutes, we already know that, and in 1 minute, there will be 60 seconds. So, that type of system is known as sexagesimal system. Now, in 1 day, there will be a complete revolution of the earth. So, we can say that 1 circumference is equals to 24 hours, and we know that 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes because in 1 hour there will be always 60 minutes and in 1 minute there will be always 60 seconds. So, that type of system is known as R system. Now, the next one is centesimal system. Now, in centesimal system, this one is new system in which 1 circumference is equals to 400 grade, 1 grade is equals to 100 centigrade and 1 centigrade is equals to 100 centigrade. That is all about the type of compass. Thank you very much, students.